Hello children, I am Priyanka Goyal, your English teacher. Today I am going to tell you a very nice story, which is chapter 5th chapter, Annie is in Trouble, of class 6. This story is about a girl, Annie. This is an extract from Annie of Green Gables. Annie Shirley is adopted by a brother and sister, Matthew and Marilla. What happened when Annie attempts to change her appearance? Listen to me, read this section. Marilla lived in Green Gables. Marilla did not expect tea to be ready. Annie was a strange girl. Okay, let's begin the story. Marilla walking home. Marilla is going to home on late April evening, realized that winter was over and gone. Spring was in the air, so the climate is very nice. Winter was gone and spring was in the air. Marilla's sober, middle-aged step was lighter and swifter because of its deep gladness. She is going fastly and she was very happy. Her eyes dwelt affectionately on Green Gables, peering through its network of trees and reflecting the sunlight back from its windows. Marilla, as she picked her steps along the damp lane, thought that it was really a satisfaction to know that she was going home to a briskly snapping firewood and a table nicely spread for tea. This happiness, she was very happy, and this happiness is about to reach her own home. And she was, as she was thinking that the tea is waiting for her on a table near a firewood, this feeling made her happy. Consequently, when Marilla entered her kitchen, but when she reached at home and when he entered the kitchen and found the fire out, no fire was there, with no sign of Annie anywhere, and Annie was also not there, she felt justly disappointed and irritated. She was expecting that the fire will be burning and the room will be cozy and the hot tea will be waiting for her, but opposite to his expectation, there was no fire, there was no tea on the table. So she felt just disappointed and irritated. She had told Annie to be sure and have tea ready at 5 o'clock. He told Annie very clearly that he told Annie to be ready with the tea by 5 o'clock, but now she must hurry and prepare the meal herself because the tea was not ready, and now Annie was not there. So she was very disappointed and irritated that now she had to prepare the meal herself. "I will settle Miss Annie when she comes home," and said Marilla grimly. Marilla said angrily, "Ki I will settle Annie when she comes home." Matthew had come in and was waiting patiently for his tea in his corner. Now, Matthew, Marilla's brother, he just came in and he was waiting for his tea. "She is off somewhere with Dinah, writing stories or practicing dialogues or some such tomfoolery means silly behavior, and never thinking once about the time or her duties. She is just go to be pulled up sharply here. Got to be pulled up sharply means to be scolded on this sort of thing. I don't care if Mrs. Allen does say she is the brightest and sweetest child she ever knew. She may be bright and sweet enough, but her head is full of nonsense, and there is never any knowing what shape it will break out in next. Just as soon as she gets out of one scrap, she gets into another. Annie has no business to leave the house like this. When I told her she was to stay home this afternoon and look after things, I must say, with all her faults, I never found her disobedient or untrustworthy before. And I am real sorry to find her so now. Well, now, said Matthew, who, being patient and wise and above all hungry, thought it best to let Marilla talk her anger out. Because Marilla was very angry because Annie was not at home. She was not there at home, and now she had to prepare the meal. She was very angry about Annie's irresponsible behavior. Matthew, her brother, want to calm her down, but he thought, let Marilla talk her anger out. He had learned by experience that she got through with whatever work was on her much quicker, if not delayed by argument. Perhaps you are judging her too hastily, Marilla. Don't call her untrustworthy until you are sure she has disobeyed you. Maybe it can all be explained. Annie's great hand at explaining. So Matthew is saying to Marilla that don't judge so quickly about Annie. Don't tell her untrustworthy before getting things explained. She is not here. When I told her to stay, retorted Marilla. Again, Marilla said that she is not here. She is not at home. I told her to stay at home. So this is a proof that she disobeyed me. I reckon she will find it hard to explain. What explanation she will give? Marilla is saying that. What explanation she will give? I told her to stay at home and she is not at home now. I knew you would take her part, Matthew. Now Marilla is saying, I know that you will take her side, Matthew, but I'm bringing her up, not you. It was dark when supper was ready, and still no sign of Annie. Now the supper is ready by Marilla, and till now there was no sign of Annie. Coming hurriedly on the log bridge, breathless and repentant, Marilla washed and put away the dishes grimly. Then, wanting a candle, she went up to the east gable for the one that generally stood on Annie's table. Lighting it, she turned around to see Annie herself lying on the bed, face downward among the pillows. Okay. Now, Marilla wants candles, and those candles were in the Annie's room. So he went to the Annie's room. When he lighted up the candle and he just turned around, what she saw? She saw that Annie was there. Annie was there on her bed, face downwards among the pillows. Mercy on us, said Marilla, astonished. When he saw the Marilla, she just astonished. Mercy on us, have you been asleep, Annie? No, she replied. Annie replied, no. Are you sick then? Annie buried herself deeper into her pillows as if desirous of hiding forever from mortal eyes. No, but please, Marilla, go away and don't look at me. When Marilla asking what happened with Annie, why she's lying on the bed, is she okay or by health or is she was sleeping, the Annie replied, no, I was not sleeping and I was and I am not sick. But Annie replied, answered the Marilla, go away and don't look at me. I am in the depth of despair and I don't care who gets ahead in class or writes the best composition or science in the Sunday school core anymore. Little things like that are of no importance now because I am suppose I will ever be able to go anywhere again. My career is closed. Please, Marilla, go away and don't look at me. So this was the reaction of Annie. What was the reason behind? Why she was so desperate? Why she was so disappointed? What was the reason? Why she was not showing her face? Why she was hiding her face in pillows? To find the answer of these questions, we will find out this question in section 2 in my next video. Till then, bye-bye. Have a nice day. Take care.